Hey there, YouTube. I am gonna go through chapter 2 of How to Speak Machine. It's called Large. Large is different than the first chapter, Loops. It switches us from time, loops, to space, sort of. I say space meaning like things that get big, or I'm also saying things that get infinitesimally small. Infinitely big, infinitely small. And the computer is strange because it's able to modulate between big or small. It can be big and be small at the same time. You know the saying of, it's really hard to find a needle in a haystack? So that means that I'll never find that needle in the haystack because there's so many little strands of hay that look like needles and I can never find it. But the thing about the computer is that it can find that needle in a haystack. It'll go do that for you. It'll also search through millions of haystacks to find that one needle. It can go large, go big, go expansive, go infinite. At the same time, it can also be simultaneously focused on your browsing habits. It can be looking at millions of people at the same time, looking through needles in a haystack while focused completely on you. And it can do that at the same time as it's searching through millions of other things in other haystacks, because it can go large, infinitely large, infinitesimally small. It's like the Powers of 10 movie, if you haven't seen that. It's quite a good little film about what happens when you zoom back out into outer space or zoom super into the size of a cell in your body. It's a piece that shows how you can go large in both directions, big or small. And the thing about people who work in this space of tech who can do this amazing stuff is that they tend to lose context, because if the medium they work in can do all that, it's kind of magical, right? Sounds a little bit hard to kind of feel. It sounds a little far-fetched, but that's what computing is all about. They lose context and they can kind of do things that maybe they shouldn't be doing, or they're like, well, it's possible here in this universe of amazingness, and I figure in my regular world I should expect everything to loop faster based on my commands, or I can like scan the entire space or zoom down to your tiny pimple and wahahaha, right? And that's one of the problems of computation. It alters your sense of reality. It changes what you can build. You can build incredible systems that can do literally anything. And yet it's a problem because it alters how we behave, think in the world. And that's why How to Speak Machine started off as a book about computation, but also became a book about what are the things you want to be working about, thinking about? Are these the right things? Definitely, especially given the medium is so powerful. But let's think what it means to speak machine, to speak human. How do you speak human better? That's the topic of the rest of the book. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you.